You can buy fancy aftermarket blade guides for most bandsaws, for example, like these blade guides. And I've always wondered, does that make much of a difference? So I've got three different styles of commercial bandsaw blade guides, plus of course my homemade blade guides. And in this video, I'll compare the four of them to see if they make much of a difference. First up, my homemade bandsaw blade guides. Next up, the cheap blade guides that came with my 14-inch bandsaw that I bought 20 years ago. The way I set the lower blade guides is so that the guides are almost pinching the blade, but it still slides freely, and the thrust bearing may be a millimeter to a half a millimeter behind the blade so it doesn't normally engage. I can't say that felt any different from using the blade guides that I made for the saw. Next up, some fancy aftermarket blade guides. These ones are from sawblade.com, but they look pretty much identical to the ones you could get from Carter. Next up, these blade guides for my friend Ted. Only problem is, this doesn't actually fit here. But no problem, I just made some more spare parts for my bandsaw. So this is not the most secure way of attaching the table, but I'm only using it for one test. Unfortunately, this part here doesn't fit on because it hits the blade guides. So, results are, here's all my samples. These ones with the homemade guides, with the cheap ones, with the sawblade.com ones, and with the guides that Ted sent me, and then I did the homemade ones again. And I have to say, when I was using them, I really couldn't tell a difference other than by looking at them. They all guided the blades perfectly well, perfectly stable. And looking at the samples, again, I can't tell the difference between one blade guide and the next. So in terms of how well they guide the blade and how clean the cut is, no difference. So I'll focus on other aspects. One aspect I expected my homemade ones to do worst in is adjustability, because these guides are kind of annoying to adjust. But I actually found these ones kind of annoying to adjust as well. Partially it was because my Allen keys just barely fit in there, so I had a hard time getting a grip with them. And then twisting these things around to get the spacing there, not so easy. These ones have really nice adjustment knobs, but then getting the fine adjustment on them was kind of awful. The easiest to adjust I found actually were these really, really cheap ones. Next criteria is bulkiness. These ones are the worst in that regard. They just obstruct the workpiece too much, especially if I'm trying to film or just trying to see what's going on. So I didn't like these at all. These ones were the best because they're tiny. And then I think these ones are still a little bit smaller than the homemade ones. So for that one, the cheap ones win. Next criteria is looks. Well, these ones just look way cool. My second favorite in terms of looks is the homemade ones, then these ones, then the big ones. And looks are actually quite important because the difference between these blade guides is largely psychological. So if the guides look really nice and precise, you'll feel better about them and you'll probably do better work with them. The clear losers in this test were these blade guides. They were sent to me by a friend, Ted, who replaced the blade guides on his bandsaw with Carter blade guides, and so he didn't need this anymore, and I thought I'd have a use for them to replace the blade guides on a bandsaw in my dad's shop, but I never got around to that. Really, these ones are meant for much wider blades, but I was running all my tests with a quarter inch blade because the narrower the blade is, the more the blade guides matter. If it's a wide blade, it's much easier to guide the blade. I have some concern about using blade guides like this, especially below the table, because all the sawdust kind of falls down right next to the blade, and these, if they're adjusted to be really close to the blade, they tend to kind of roll that sawdust, compress it onto the blade, so that's not such a good idea. These ones, they do roll very quietly. I mean, they're brand new, and they look like they're very high quality ball bearings, so they weren't really noisy in that regard, although that could change if they're used for a long time. Now, of course, some people say you're meant to adjust these so that the rollers don't actually touch the blade, but then if you have a significant gap between the rollers and the blade, well, then you're not really effectively guiding the blade. These ones were the easiest to adjust. You just loosen those screws and lightly push the blocks against the blade and tighten them, and then make sure it's not too tight. And the thrust bearing is pretty easy to adjust too. And they're very small. I think there was originally some set screws in here, but I replaced them with these bolts just so I didn't have to look for the Allen key all the time. This lower blade guide I don't think is entirely optimal because you adjust it just by loosening the screws that attach it to the frame. And also, I think it would be better to have the guide blocks above the thrust bearing instead of below, just to get the guidance closer to where the stock is. But neither these blade guides nor these ones can be used with particularly wide blades. Whereas these homemade ones have got really wide guide blocks, and then I can have the blade actually sticking out past the back of the guide blocks, so I can run these with an inch and a quarter sawmill blade, which is something these can't do, although these ones could use a sawmill blade as well. So my advice is, whatever blade guides your bandsaw came with, they work just fine. And if you have to replace your blade guides, maybe consider getting some really cheap ones, because I actually like those the best.